Welcome to a brand new episode of Smile Prachi. This is Prachi. And starting with the first writer of the day, let's call our first writer Wicket. Okay, Wicket. Wicket says, "Hey, so I'm a 36-year-old guy married with 4 kids. My wife is a housewife. It's a huge burden for me to take care of everybody's financial needs. I live in a city away from my parents, who, by the way, are quite well-to-do. I've asked them and a few of my close relatives for help and support at a few times. Not for myself, but for my kids, so I can get them to better schools, etc. But every single time, I was refused help. This has been going on for years. Recently, my aunt's husband got hit by COVID and the whole family flooded in to help them with money. My parents shelled out lakhs for his treatment and 1 month hospital stay. I don't understand what I'm doing wrong. My wife blames my lack of convincing abilities. But even if that was the issue, what kind of grandparents would not want to help their own grandkids get a better life? Or should I give this another chance and try to talk to them? I'm really, really hurt, Prachi." Wicket, since you have written this letter to me, let me just start by saying that you know me, right? I don't sugarcoat things, and I will just tell you things as it is. I will call a spade a spade. So I'm going to give you some harsh reality checks today. Don't take it to your heart. See it as a lesson learned, okay? First of all, you're not a 36-year-old guy. You're a 36-year-old man. You're grown up now. You're not a child anymore. You have children of your own, and you have 4 children. See, it's very important, and this is not specifically for you, this is for my viewers in general, that when you plan to have kids, please plan your kids to be at par with your finances and how much money can you really provide for these children. Some people, yes, they can afford to provide for more kids. If you don't have that kind of money, have 1 or 2 children. Instead of living your entire life with that worry, with that fear of how to provide for them, how to take care of them, their financial needs, and then scolding the children, that's not fair to you and for the child. So it's very important to plan these kind of things very well, and these have to go hand in hand with how much money you have. Okay? It's a very practical advice. A lot of people might say that, you know, motherhood and parenthood should not work like that. Actually, that's exactly how it should work. All right? It has to start with a sense of responsibility. Number 3, Wicket, let me be very honest with you. You're not entitled to your parents' money. I know in India we have this culture where it is expected that, you know, your parents will take care of you for your entire life. A lot of times, you know, parents, when they pass away, they don't give any inheritance to the children, and the children are really angry about it. Sure, it can hurt a little bit because, you know, again, it's a cultural norm. But we have to understand that we are not entitled to our parents' money. It's their money and they can do whatever they want to do with it. I don't have the right to question them. I don't even have the right to expect that they will give me anything. Now that I'm an adult myself, right? And here's one more thing that you need to understand, Wicket. Hear me out very carefully. There is a whole world of difference between helping somebody who is facing a, you know, life-threatening illness. One is something that you cannot predict or expect to happen. You know, that's an illness. And the other one is just a choice that you made in your life. A proper, consciously made choice. So it's completely all right. And honestly, it's completely understandable if your parents do not want to support you right now. Here's what you need to do. For the benefit of your children, I'll give you some advice and hear me. I mean, just think about it, okay? I understand as a parent, you want to send your children to the best of schools, but if you can't afford that, that's all right. Send them to a good school where they will learn the value of, you know, respecting people, value of hard work, value of discipline, and give them a happy, strong, nurturing environment at home. Give them a lot of love. Teach them the right values. Teach them how to live their life. Teach them how to be independent. Believe it or not, no matter how much money you spend on their education, I know a lot of kids who went to some of the most expensive schools in the country, but who just still can't stand on their own 2 feet today. And I know a lot of children who just about managed, you know, in like really, really basic schools, but they're doing very well in life. It all comes down to how the children are raised at home. That's a very important part. That's the most important part of your child's upbringing. So focus more on that instead of focusing on the money aspect of it, focusing on the, you know, how expensive the school is, because that's anyways not going to make a huge difference to your child's life, if at all, really, okay? The next writer of the day, we're going to call the next writer of the day bat. Okay, bat. Bat says, "Hi Prachidi, I'm 15 years old and I hate school. I hate the education system, how it works, and anyways, I know my calling is to have my own startup one day. I don't believe in working for someone else, so why should I study for someone else either? My parents don't get me. I agree I fail a lot of subjects, I procrastinate, get lazy, and miss my project deadlines. But that's because I'm just not interested. The other day, my older sister caught me watching a movie while my online classes were on, and she flipped like nobody's business. I asked her to get out of the room and had a huge fight with my parents that day. It was my history class and I don't give a damn about history. I know that when is the right time for me, I will step up and I will do very well. Why can't they just have some faith in me and stop with the stupid yelling all the time? How should I make them just stop?" You know, but I'll tell you something, okay? There's something that I learned in my psychology class. We were having a class and my teacher, she asked us, She was actually telling us this. She said that, you know, when a teacher enters the class, it's very important for her to know this, that there are three types of students in the class. Most of the students will have average intelligence. Most of the students, okay? Some students will have above average intelligence and some students will have below average intelligence. Then she's saying, who do you think will do the best in life? The children with average intelligence or above average intelligence or the one with the below average intelligence? Obviously, the whole class said, you know, the students with the above average intelligence will end up doing well. That's how the world is today, you know. And then we start discussing about all those famous, you know, people who, you know, just left school midway and didn't complete their education and now they are doing so well in life. And, you know, all of those examples that we started giving. My teacher said, "Stop. That's exactly where you guys are going wrong. Statistically, it's usually the students with the average intelligence who end up doing better than those with the above average intelligence. And that's statistics. You know why? Because the students with average intelligence tend to work harder. They work hard because they know that they're not going to get good marks in the exams unless they work hard. The ones with the above average intelligence, they might be getting coming first in class, second in class, doing very well in the exams and everything, but they are not putting a lot of effort into it because they are extremely intelligent. They just get it without really working hard for it. So in the race of life, when they really have to face the real world, they start falling behind very fast. Whereas those who are used to working hard end up doing much better. You get the logic behind this? I am not saying support the education system. I agree, it's very badly flawed. But there are things, see, in life, since you want to have your own business and all that one day, let me just tell you this, okay? In life, always be open to learning from other people. Whether you like them, hate them, whatever, every human being that you meet will have something very interesting to say, and sometimes you can actually learn from them. You don't have to agree with everything that they say. You don't even have to hero worship them. But sometimes people can make a lot of sense when you least expect them to do. So here's the thing with the education system. You may not approve of it, you may not support it, and I understand that completely. But there is something that our education system, especially in India, teaches us, and that is hard work. Because the exams are so tough, you know, because everything is so difficult and competitive, we end up working harder, which goes on to explain as to why Indians are some of the highest achieving people in the world, because you work hard. Number one. Number two, you say in your letter that your parents need to start having some faith in you. I'm sorry, but what frame of reference do your parents have to have faith in you? They see you procrastinating. They see you being lazy. They see you failing your subjects. They see you not working hard enough. They see you not taking any responsibilities. Obviously, your parents will not have faith in you. And here's the thing, you're just 15 years old. Honestly, at this age, at 15, you need to listen to your parents. You need to respect your parents. You need to respect your parents throughout your life, in fact. You don't always have to agree with what they are saying. But what you're saying about yelling and fighting and everything and, you know, that's not nice. And there's a reason why you're not considered an adult yet. Till you're in your early 20s, even your brain is still developing. Physically, your brain is still developing. You are not at a position where you can take major decisions of your life right now. You shouldn't be doing that. Because there will be a lot of things that you'll not be able to understand at this point of time. You're not designed for it at the moment. Okay? So here's what I would suggest you to do. I'm not saying that you need to, start scoring very well in class or doing very well in class, but start putting some more effort into your studies. See it as a training for your business, dreams in future. Even as a businessman, you're a businesswoman, you're a girl, right? So even as a businesswoman, you will have to do a lot of things that you don't enjoy. For example, it could be something as simple as accounting. Maybe you don't enjoy accounting, but sometimes you will have to sit with the financial team and make plans and look at the accounts. So see it as a training for that, to do something that you don't enjoy doing, but you have to do anyway. Start working a little bit on your studies. Make sure that you don't fail your exams. Try to aim for average marks in all of your subjects and leave it at that. Even if you're not coming first in class, that's fine. And after that, start developing skills. If possible, maybe take up a part-time job. You're 15 years old. So maybe if you have some skills like dancing, singing that you could teach to the children in your neighborhood, or if you could do something else, there are a lot of things that you can do at your age, really, at these, during these times. So look up those kind of things. Get some hands-on experience as to how the outside world functions, how things go on in life when you start earning your own money. What are the things that you need to learn? Sit down with your parents. Ask them questions about these things. Plan out your future ahead. Use your time wisely. Don't procrastinate and be lazy, because that will not help you. You need to learn how to slog in life to be successful. And most importantly, remember that even if you're extremely successful in life one day, that success will not last, and the success will definitely not make you happy if the people around you don't love you or are not happy with you. You need to respect your relationships. You need to respect your family. So be good to your sister. They are coming from a place of genuine concern. They're not coming from a place of trying to attack you, all right? So don't go there. And a lot of times, the things that you have mentioned, a lot of times people go through this kind of stage, this kind of phase when they're not feeling motivated or inclined to doing anything. A lot of times, it's also because of depression or other mental health issues. If you think there could be something of that sort, please, by all means, go get therapy. Tell your parents that you're not feeling motivated, you're not feeling good, you feel guilty about not working hard enough, but you just don't feel motivated and that you need help. So you would want to speak to a professional to learn how to manage your thoughts, and go for therapy. Go for a couple of sessions. It will help you a lot, right? So yes, guys, that's all I want to share with my two writers of the day. Oh my god, I'm just realizing how bright everything around me is. It's actually really sunny outside. I'm sitting in front of the curtain. So anyways, so guys, that's all I wanted to share with my two writers of the day. Let me know in the comment section below if you've gone through something similar, if you have experienced something similar, if you know someone who has gone through something similar, what your stories are, what your suggestions are. Especially, I think the second letter is something that a lot of us go through. What Ball is going through right now. A lot of children, they get so fed up, and of course the exam pressure, the school pressure is honestly too much at times. But it's very important to understand that the value of education may not always lie in, all the things that you're being taught in the class, but more on the values that you're being taught. And don't let go of those values. In today's video, I think I've used this term a lot, the values. But it's really the most important part of growing up. Learning discipline, learning the value of hard work, learning that, okay, if I have a deadline, I have to finish my work by this and this deadline. So in your student life, it's like finishing my project by the deadline. Don't procrastinate, don't waste your time. Yeah, maybe your teacher will accept your project the next day as well, but try to finish it by your deadline. Make it a habit to work hard, to slog, to learn from people, to respect everybody. These are things that will genuinely take you far in life. I'm not saying you have to be nice to everybody and be friends with everybody, but in general, just be more open about these things, okay? So yes, guys, that's all I wanted to share in today's video. Thank you so much for watching. Have a great weekend, everybody. This is me, Prachi, signing off now. Bye-bye.